And welcome back, broodlings, to more Pillars of Eternity. Fast mode. We're heading to Raedric's keep to kill or him again, or kill the usurper who's taken his place. We are newly rested, or actually rested several times to finish the friggin' grieving mother thing. Hurling payday. Grand adventure. Firebrand is assigned. That got rid of it. Okay, not getting that, really. Oh, hey! What was it again? The training grounds. Done. Look at that, guys. Everything done. Of course, we would have been done way before now if things didn't get undone. Never gonna bother sneaking. Let's just boldly stride forth. I don't know if this place is filled with undead, or it's gonna be empty, or we're gonna have friendly people. Oh, undead, okay. As you approach the smiling woman at the side of the road, you are struck with a sense of unease. At this distance, you can see that her skin has a sickly, pallid sheen to it, and her eyes are the glassy milk-white of a cadaver. Her expression sits oddly on her face, as if it requires great effort to maintain.
Hello.
Lord Raedric has been expecting you.
The woman smiles a little wider.
It is good that you have not refused his challenge. He feared you might prove a coward in the end.
So you know I'm destroying that voice. I will escort you to him if you wish. What the hell are you?
A loyal servant granted a boon for her good service. Like my lord, I will persist beyond the cycle and walk in eternity upon the earth. Seek answers from him directly if you want them.
Yes, take me to him.
Come then, he waits for you there. She points up toward the topmost tower of the keep and leads the way over the drawbridge.
I suppose otherwise we'll have to fight hordes of undead, which could be fun in and of itself, but let's just follow her. I have fast mode on. Turn it off. And here we are. Lord Raedric waits for you upon the tower.
Okay.
And there, the temple, I guess? What if you go up here instead? Are there hordes of undead? Oh, hello. Well, he's over here. Hi. How you doing? An armored figure strides forward. In place of its eyes, great flames burn, emanating heat and light. In that orange glow, you could see that the face beneath has succumbed to rot, the cheeks sunken, the lips pulled back over gray gums and decaying teeth. But it is unmistakably Raedric who stands before you. Oh my god, we gotta kill this guy twice.
Look well. See what you have made of me. But see, too, what great Bereth has permitted. I am returned, mind and soul, so that I might be avenged upon my enemies.
Geez, thanks a lot, Bereth. Radric's voice has gained a scratchy quality, but retains its stolid arrogance.
Well, yeah, it's got an echoing, reverberating quality as well. All I see is a walking corpse. Okay, it's not going to talk.
Then your eyes are deceived. You cannot imagine the power bestowed upon me. I feel the touch of the gods. My faith is a font from which I draw life. My wrath is a weeping flame, and you will burn this day.
I have strangled the life from the usurper Kolsch with my own hands. So fell your champion, your great hope.
He's our champion. He raises a fist in demonstration, clenching rotting fingers.
We just did a quest for him. He's not our champion.
Was that creature to be your thane?
A man without resolve, without aim? A leech, growing fat upon the Vale, senseless to the ravages his vanity inflicted upon his people. No. Adair sounds as bad as the alternative.
I will not allow my lands to fall into ruin. I will cleanse the scattered god's poison from the blood of my people. I will scour his name from the Deerwood. Bereth has blessed me with its favor, and I will be its sword. There will be no more mercy for the heretic, the thief, the charlatan. All will meet with death.
Well, there's obviously no reasoning with this guy. Why would we want to reason with him? He's undead. Then fight me, you'll know justice. Enough of your damn talking. Bereth itself. Interesting question. You're going to waste your second chance at life fighting me again? I have been brought back to exact Bereth's vengeance upon the mortal world. This is no waste. Know that I will cleave your head from your shoulders, wretch, and send you cleanly from this world. May the next life provide you with more wisdom than you have shown in this one. Well, thanks, but I'm not planning on you being correct there. Dun, dun. Okay, Holy Radiance. Disintegrate this guy, if we can. Boom. Chain Lightning. Knockdown. There's probably gonna be undead running in the way, getting in the way anyway, but...
Wait.
Okay. So knock this down. I can try to carry that out. We're very damaged. Restore major endurance. Where's Canna? Vampire Guardsman. Oh, Lord Raedric's right there. Alright. I'll knock down the Lord Raedric. He's still casting that. He's about to cast it. You see his motions there. Theodos turned evil. Suppress affliction. Oh, he ran away. I still haven't cast this frickin' disintegration thing. On Lord Raedric, please. Chain Lightning. Throw on those heals. Let's say
We need it over here, this crowd. Who is she attacking? Oh, Ken, are you using your frickin' gun? Oh, stop that. Oh, boy. On a dare this time. He's a high one. He has a lot of hit points. Oh god, it turned evil again. Suppress affliction. Alright, Theodas. Let's try to kill this guy if we can. She's using a bow. What are we doing? We're running away from Lord Raedric. Boom. Oh, sheesh. Oh my god. Oh, she's out. Alright, reviving exhortation on it there. Okay. Okay, gonna cast that somewhere. Cast it here. Blast of frost. Yeah, we can do that. Oof. On's pledge. Next one. Going on Amethyst. Oh, he ran! Damn it. Oh, sheesh, man. Gon's pledge again. Is he casting that? Aeloth. You know what? Attack him. That's why I'm almost dead. I have them all on me. You know what? Lay on hands. There's Durance aimed at me as well. Oh god, she's out! Does the priest have that? What does it look like? Did she turn evil, Pelagina? No. Oh, I have another one? Or I haven't used it yet. Theodas. Oh, that right. Doesn't a dare get back up? Man. Getting bashed to hell here. Durance? Kanna? Aeloth? Durance and Aeloth. Disintegration. Really need to start getting rid of some foes. How about on the Famp here? You can hit him. Kanna, do your sweep. Whatever the hell it's called. Clear out. Blast of Frost. And I think that's everybody. Ken, are you doing anything? Hit the Famp here. Actually, no, are you tied to this? I think you're tied to him, even though he's not facing you. Well, hit that, then. Hit something! Oh, that reminds me. We're up to 4. We can call... three worms. Based on Raedric. Healing time. Oh sheesh, Theodos again. I'm out of uses of that. Suppress affliction here. Damn it. Did you heal yet? What happened? Oh, he turned evil. Potion of Major Recovery. No, that's not what I'm looking for. Eldritch Aim, Iron Skin, Wizard's Double. Buy a little time. I don't know if Palagino could even get to him. Sheesh, can we kill one of these things? Oh, he's out. He's out. He's still evil. Suppress affliction again. Then maybe the priest can bring him back, I'm not sure. Okay, he's good. Palagina, lay on hands for yourself. While Durance... what does it look like? Kind of like a mushroom cloud or a fist or something? It's yellow. What is this? Looking, I don't see it. Nope. Alright, I don't know what you can do other than heal all of us left. Sucks. These guys keep running all over the frickin' place. This Famp here is almost dead. clear out. Oh yeah, knock them all down. That'd be awesome. Awesome! Although we need help over here. Where is she? This is her? No. Durance, Canna. Dare. Palagina, where are you? I'm guessing maybe she's here in front of him? In front of Canna? Oh no, she turned evil again. Crap. Do I have any more uses of that spell? It looks like someone's head, kinda. This one. Theodas. Okay, she's casting that. Adair. Hit the vampire. Canna, hit the vampire. Durance is back. I guess you have to defend yourself against Raedric for a sec. Alright, done. Adair, hit that. Oh, wait, no, he was gonna cast... I forgot who was doing it. Suppress affliction. Oh, she's back. Never mind. Now heal her. Oh, she's down. It's too freaking late. Damn it. We kill that one? Right, hit that one. Hit him. Everybody hit him.
I'm ready.
Well, the vampire guardsman's still here. Oh god, this is what's killing us. We keep switching back to our... Put the bows away, man. Yeah, hit that. Actually, no, you can go around. You're not attached to him. Yes. Little healing. Oh, turn him evil again. I have to heal. I can't really do it right now. God. Can't keep up. These are really low healings. Hey, what happened to my drakes? Did he ever cast them? Bring the big drake. Destroy. He might have turned evil right before it appeared. Heal again. That's all I can do.
But...
Maybe... Palagina, do you have a... No, she's all out of lay on hands. Field triage. On Durance. Did she do it? She cast it, okay. Big guy, you attack him too, okay? And Kana. Every time they get taken over, they switch to a different weapon set. Yay! That was quite an obstacle. Quite an ordeal. I have defeated Lord Raedric the Seventh, for once and for all. I hope. Holy crap, Aurelia. And we can all level up. Where are you going?
No problem.
What the fuck? Major adventure added. Heravius. Bring your beast into form. Grand adventure. Sagani. Okay, we need to level everyone up. Exceptional sword, large shield. Ooh, some kind of unique heavy armor there. Vessel flesh. Two flesh vessel bones and 201 copper skeets. He carries many scars, unique heavy armor. Damage reduction 14. Recovery minus 50%. It's heavy armor. So it's fine, so it has plus 2 damage reduction, plus 50% armor damage reduction, 125% health, and plus 1 endurance per 3 seconds. But that's pretty sweet. Doesn't make that much difference. 1 endurance every 3 seconds. This armor was forged in honor of the Red Saren monk Rungenfar, who came to believe that as long as no enemy could inflict more pain upon him than he could upon himself, he could never truly be subjugated by anyone. Conscripted by his government to quell the uprisings inspired by Saint Widwin, Rungenfar became a frightful presence on the battlefield. For every injury he sustained at the hands of an enemy, he would inflict one twice as severe, drawing strength from the pain that enabled him to fight through injuries that would have caused anyone else to collapse on the ground. He could change his enemies, covered in blood with tears in his skin, from hand to foot, and his foes would shrink at the sight of him, believing as he did that it was not in their power to injure such a man. Near the end of the rebellion, when the rebels had all but overthrown the government, Rungfar found himself in a battle defending against St. Widwin's main forces. Accounts claim that he was the last on his side to remain alive, and he was approached by St. Widwin himself in the end. As the story goes, the living god looked him over and gave a slight bow, permitting him to fall upon his own blade, that he might remain free. The armor bears many artificial scars added by the blacksmith to make its wearer as imposing as the figure that inspired it, though it wears its real scars with equal pride. Maybe for Kana? I'm not sure. He might be the only one wearing heavy armor. Maybe Pelagina. Let's get the rest of this crap. Yeah. Alright. There's a trunk here that we can unlock. I'm assuming it's still here. Okay, let's level everyone up. Level 12. I'm not sure what the cap is. Maybe it is 12, maybe it's 15. Alright, well let's add to... Survival. And I'll save the points for the next level. Mind Plague. The only one we have for level 6? What do we give everything else already? Destroys an enemy's memory with calculated accuracy, confusing and dazing them before rapidly jumping up to 5 other enemies. So we have effect foe target plus 5 jump targets. Dazed and confused. Yeah, it's a movie. For 26 seconds. And ditto for the jump targets. Yeah, I guess I'm taking this one, because there's nothing else here. Psychic backlash. Yes, take it. Will defense. I mean, it's going to happen sometimes. That was quick, and let's do the others. Survival. Sitzel's martial power. Can I take a 5 instead? Yeah. Wondrous torment. Malignant cloud, I like that. Bitter mooring. Torrent of flame. Let's take the bitter mooring, actually. Target is hit with a stuck affliction and becomes an anchor for a frigid ray of energy from the wizard that does freeze damage to enemies in its path. So not only it gets stuck, but you emanate something that can damage your, you know, your friends who are attacking us as well. Twenty-one to 30 freeze, stuck for about 4 seconds, and it has a beam. 20 to 30 freeze, versus fortitude. Oh, and they get stuck too, stuck for 4 seconds. Okay. What do we want here? Talents. Hardened veil strengthens the wizard arcane veil, providing a particularly high deflection bonus. Pretty cool. Penetrating blast. Concentrates the power of blast, negating some of the target's damage reduction. Well, I think we're going to take this. Foe AoE, 6 to 10 crush. Yeah. I'll take that. Because we use blasts a lot. I mean, I think we do. Isn't that like fireball and stuff? Hopefully. Let me just look.
How may I help?
Doesn't say if it's a blast or not. Second. Blast of frost. Maybe it's just everything that's called blast something. We'll try to use that more often in that case. Adair, my man. I'm going to save his points for next level. Weapon mastery, knight. Increased refinement and dedication to the techniques used with a fighter's chosen weapons. Mastery grants an additional bonus on top of the standard bonuses provided by weapon specialization. Passive plus 10% damage with sword, which he has. Yeah, we'll take that. Endurance. Saving points for future mechanics. I don't know if I can go any higher, but it says 10 points to advance. So maybe we just need another point. Empowered interdiction talent. Plus 10 accuracy. The priest's condemnations of an enemy become more apt, increasing the accuracy of his or her interdiction ability. Oh, and this tells you about interdiction, okay. Inspired flame. The faithful of Magrin. Well, he knows Margren's not real anymore. Or not that Margren's not real, actually, because he rewinded back to when he says Margren has betrayed him. So I'm not sure why he still has powers, because he's lost that belief. But I'm glad he hasn't lost it, that would stink. Anyway, he gains an accuracy bonus with sword and arquebus, and can cast a special version of Burst of Summer Flame. Well, he's using a staff. So... yeah. Let's skip that. Aggrandizing Radiance. Everyone receives less healing from the Priest Holy Radiance. Oh, yeah. Attributes and movement. Okay. Let's take a... maybe I should be using Interdiction more often. I don't know. You know, I'm thinking more healing, actually. Fourth level spell I'm gonna take. I was really torn between the two. If you stop flying down there, I'd appreciate it. Now, Pelagina. Let's take, survival. Critical focus. Allies notice the paladin's zeal and become thoroughly inspired by it. Allies affected by zealous focus convert 5% of ordinary hits to crits. Deep faith. The intensity of the paladin's faith deepens, granting them increased defensive bonuses to faith and constitution. Modifies +2 deflection and +5 fortitude, reflex, and will. That's pretty sweet. Let's take that. And finally, Kana. Last but not least. Gonna save his points. What do we have here? 2 fearsome ogres, nice. This is all third as well. As the Drake. Rise again. Huh. That might be helpful. Even though they'll only have a small amount of endurance, they'll have 62. Maybe quick, you know, enough time for to be healed. Attacks enemies in 7 directions around the Chanta with bolts of freezing ice. Sweet. Empowers allies in the area of effect with bonuses to dexterity, perception, intellect. +5 for all. And empowers with +5 my constitution resolve. Let us do this rise again thing. Talents, beloved spirits. Improves the chanter's connection to the soul fragments they employ, increasing ancient memory's healing capability. Ancient memory. Must be chanting. Maybe I could take weapon focus on this S-Talk he uses. Is he using an S-Talk? Let me look at this.
Following your lead.
Yeah, he's still using regular fine S-Talk. Should probably change that, but I don't know. Do I have anything currently here? It's only a fine weapon. How about an exceptional sword? +8 accuracy, +30% damage. Where's the fine? It should say fine, colon, somewhere. Hmm. Anything else? give him that. And we'll enchant it as much as we can. How do we get enchanting requirements up? Burn damage. Slaying. Beast. I mean, maybe we have to level up by doing this stuff. Do a higher level one. Potions level 4. Major endurance. I like those. Why can I just increase here? Your regeneration. Only using one of those for every two or something, I don't know. How do I go up in crafting? All these potions, I gotta sort this out off screen. We can only carry like 5 in a stack. Yeah, it's another long episode.
Right away.
Can't go that way. No stragglers, come on, kinda. Hello, Vampire. No, he doesn't, not anymore. Is this place empty or full of vampire things? This goes to the kitchen, upper ramparts, or outer bailey. To the chapel, to the crypts. I think we went out this way. When I get to that chest I never opened, probably has stuff that is not useful to us now. It was so long ago. Thankfully, so far, appears to be empty. killed enough stuff on our first way through here. It's not this stuff, is it? Then we got it already. That goes down, this goes out. No, I think it was separate. It was like a whole separate room. It was an armory. Oh, it's not that way then. Come down. That's that alternate way down that we can take. I don't know. To Temple Armory. Okay, down the stairs and over here. I always meant to come back here and I forgot all about it. Ooh!
Something over there!
We found a hidden thing and we weren't even sneaking. Another potion of Eldritch Aim, as if we needed more of those. We just crafted like 12 of them or something. Alright, so this is the armory. And that's the courtyard. Let's go into sneak.
Shh.
Yeah, we can pick that easily now.
A simple test.
Yeah, now it is. Find breastplate and brigandine. Just really want to see what's in there. No traps?
A simple test.
Quarterstaff and a fine large shield. Oh, I forgot to level him up. Now that he has a regular sword, right? Let me just check. Yep, it's exceptional sword, so I can do this. Oh, I'm not gonna take anything, right? Nope. Save the points. Reviving the allies. Probably focus knight. Battle axe sword, we'll do that. Okay, pretty freaking sure that we don't have anything else to do. That we've explored everything. Climb back down. Done. Any more undeads? Nothing upon the road. Well, glad we killed him. Again. Back to Cadnua. Okay. Off screen, we will rest. I will make sense of all this crap in our inventory. And then we'll head back down to the Endless Pass of Adnua, level 12, I believe, we're exploring. The rabbit hole goes down farther and farther. So thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. And enduring, go strong.